And what is that one answer?
That it's the self, it's all.
No, the answer is that the question is stupid. And hence there is no answer. Silence is the answer.
So, is there any expression of love in this, in the sense?
This is love. The ego being attracted to the peace of the self. That attraction is called love. The mind is restless. It wants to get rest, peace, silence. This want is love. Bhakti yoga and jnana yoga are not at all different, but because we live in differences, so we want to ensure and believe that jnana and bhakti are different. That is why in a text of Advaita Vedanta, the bhakti yogis are rarely interested. They say, no, but it is not talking of love. But what else do you read here? It is love, love and love, nothing else. We want to divide. We want to categorize this as that and that as something else. When a Dattatreya speaks, he is beyond categorization. You cannot call him as talking of Advaita or Vedanta or Jnana or Prem or Bhakti. I find only love here. Love is not about being attracted to a person. Love is the desire of the mind to settle into peace. Silence calls. This calling is called love. The great emptiness beckons. This beckoning is called love. But if you are someone who lives a superficial life, then you will say, where is love written here? I do not see L-O-V-E. Come on. Learn to read deeper than words. Let us read the Narad Bhakti Sutra. Only there does the word love come. Now has it come to this, that we'll have to depend on words for love? Then surely your love is just words. And that is what usually our love is. Lot of words, right? Beginning with I love you. Words. Remove this distinction. It is a fake distinction. Bhakti and Jnana are one. For truth is one. All the different branches of yoga are one. Yoga itself is one. Have you ever seen a pondering frog? Have you ever seen a heavy rabbit? Have you ever seen a bird close its eyes trying to meditate? They are all right. Only man is full of important things. One of the most important things is the God thing.